get ready to match the stars. Gary Berghoff, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Sarah Kennedy, Richard Dawson, and Fanny Flay as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 76. And now, here's the star of Match Game 76, Gene Rivers.
Johnny O and friends, are you all ready? I hear you got a dynamite nightclub act. Do you do tap dancing in your act?
Yeah, I do. Well, I do soft shoeing, little vaudeville shtick.
Really?
Yeah, we do some up-to-date things too, but I love the old-time stuff.
Yeah, well, that's nice. Everything. Are you sick?
No, Fanny's sick. I'm Fanny's wonderful. Sick.
Okay.
My disease is not contagious, it's just terminal.
Oh. Now let's say hello to our current champ here, Joe Beyer, Jr. Hello, Joe. How do you feel today?
Nervous.
You think you're going to do it? You feel it in your bones?
I hope so.
I hope so, too. He's got $950, and we had to quit just before he had to go at the $5,000 last time. We'll see how he does. Either he collects it or he doesn't collect it. That's the way it is here. There's no gray area. We'll do that right after we do this. All right, here we are with Joe Beyer, Jr. He's been up here the second time now. And the first time around, he did not collect the $5,000. And we'll see if he's going to do that now. Before we can pay that amount of money, Joe, you've got to match one of our celebrities exactly. An exact match. Which one will it be?
Richard, please.
Richard, get ready to write. You swing around, face me. Joe, here's the number that's worth $5,000. Goes like this. Blank scotch. S-C-O-T-C-H. Blank scotch. Blank scotch. Now he's finished, Joe. What answer do you want to give us? Which you think will match his? Get your ESP going, thought waves transmitted over to Richard Dawson. See if he can come up and tell us the same answer he's written already on the card.
Hop.
Yeah! Hopscotch. I suppose there are other answers, but hopscotch is the only thing I could think of. Are there other answers?
Valentine's, Dewars.
Butterscotch, yeah.
Butterscotch.
Dewars and no, not rat, no. What do you say, Richard? He says that'll match a hopscotch for a $5,000 bill.
Yeah!
Congratulations. Anybody here with you? Three beautiful people right there. Great. John and Judy in Maryland.
Friends of yours?
Yes.
Oh, they're very happy for you. Okay. Yep. Thank you very much. There they are, his friends now. You have a grand total of $5,950, and it doesn't have to stop there, Joe. Let's see how you do against Barbara Raskin. Hello, Barbara. How are you, my dear? Good. Okay, you can climb aboard the merry-go-round, Joe. It stopped, and we'll find out a little bit about Barbara.
Okay, I'm Barbara Raskin.
You're Barbara Raskin. I thought I heard that someplace. What do you say, Barbara?
I'm from El Paso, Texas.
Yep.
I'm an airplane pilot.
You're an airplane pilot?
Yes, okay. Private pilot.
Yeah.
I'm the director of two lovely daycare centers, and I'm a registered nurse. My husband's an Army doctor, and I have one little boy named Dean. And
what's that?
This is for Gary.
Thank you.
Lovely thought. Barbara, that's very sweet of you to do that. I guess you've seen him
yes.
fondle his teddy bear on mat.
I beg
yes,
your
that's
pardon.
Right.
Well, you love your teddy bear.
Sir, there are young people watching.
You know, it's an astounding thing how many men went to World War II, to Korea, to Vietnam, and took their childhood symbols, their teddy bears with them, as security symbols. It's an incidental statistic that happens to be in my head. What else would you like to know, Patty?
Well,
now, Barbara, are you ready to play?
Yes,
anything
I am.
Anything else you want to tell us about you?
No.
Okay. Good luck to you. I'll push the button. Reveal our first round questions. Ask you to make a selection.
B, please.
B it is. All yours. Count Dracula, Seb.
Yes.
Washington, D.C. is a dangerous place. Last night, a man from the blank tried to suck my blood. That's what he said. A dangerous place. Last night, a man from the blank here in Washington tried to suck my blood. Oh. Very good. May I smell your rose?
Yes.
Very fragrant.
All right?
Sure.
Okay. Here we go.
I'm ready.
Charles, ready? Now we'll call up Barbara Raskin.
Count Dracula said Washington, D.C. is a dangerous place. Last night, a man from the blank tried to suck my blood.
The Congress.
You do not understand what I am talking about. I hope someone will come up with a good answer that will make it clear what I am trying to say.
It was a very strange occurrence, but what was even stranger yet was 6 weeks later, the same guy came along and tried to give him an audit. I said the IRS.
IRS is the answer. Very good, Gary. Brett?
Keep going, kids. Don't quit while we're ahead. The Internal Revenue Place building or what have you.
All right. That's it. Charles?
The Treasury Department.
Treasury Department. I think that's a little different from the IRS, but in any case, Barbara's looking for the answer, the Congress. Sarah, what do you say?
I said the big White House.
The White House?
Yeah. Oh,
yeah, well, there's been some funny stuff going on there from time to time.
Income tax board.
The board. Right. Do you get the point now, Barbara?
I think so.
What do you say?
I said the internal revenue.
The revenueers.
Okay. Card.
There's a $5,000 winning card for you, Joe, as a souvenir. And while you're looking that over and waiting for your first round question, we'll do a little business with America. All right. Here we go with the other half of round one. Joe Beyer, this is your first rounder. As you know, sometimes they're tough. Dumb Dora is so dumb.
How dumb is she?
I tell you, she stayed up all night studying for a blank test.
Oh, got it.
She's so dumb, she stayed up all night studying for a blank test. Finished. Your mother was in show business, wasn't she?
Yes, she was.
She danced.
Yeah, how'd you know that?
You told me once. Oh. She was a tap dancer and a terrific
right.
one.
She was wonderful.
Well, you're all ready. Here we
on
go,
on the
Joe.
Walls, she could dance.
Dumb Dora so dumb, she stayed up all night studying for a blank test.
I can't think of the name for it, but the test for pregnancy? The rabbit test?
The rabbit test? All right. All right, we'll call it a pregnancy test.
Studying for a rabbit test.
Stayed up all night studying for a pregnancy test.
That's the rabbit test.
The rabbit test,
you're
yeah.
Right. If you're pregnant, the rabbit dies.
And I don't want to hear about it.
And they were shedding all night long.
She oh,
woke,
really?
She woke up in a big ball of fur. It's true.
Come on, show us your card.
Why? I haven't got anything else to do. I said a blood test.
Blood test is a very good answer. Excellent answer. What do you say?
Well, I said a blood or Wasserman, which is the same thing.
Yes, of course. Charles?
Three bloods,
okay. Now, Sarah.
Yes.
Dumb Dora so dumb stayed up all night studying for a blank test.
Absolutely. Blood.
A blood test.
Oh.
Richard, what'd you say?
Blood.
Gosh, you would have done well if you'd said blood there. Fanny, we're up to you.
I know, I'm just thinking about those poor rabbits Brett's killed.
Hundreds of them.
I said a pap test.
Okay.
How dare you smear the show?
So, in round one, we have no score. We go to round two and ask Barbara to make her selection.
B.
B again? So. Everybody plays in round two because she didn't match anybody in round one.
Okay.
Judy said my honeymoon was rotten.
She's not alone.
Rotten honeymoon.
What rotten was it?
Sure, Sidney took me to Niagara Falls, but when we got there, he made me blank. The rotten honeymoon.
Huh?
My husband took me to Niagara Falls, but when we got there, he made me blank. The rotten question, isn't it? Rotten honeymoon, rotten question.
Thanks.
Well, we've got to do something with it. Do the best you can.
All right, once more.
All right.
Into the breach, oh, you're...
Judy said, my honeymoon was rotten. Sure, Sidney took me to Niagara Falls, but when we got there, he made me blank. Feeling any better? Good. All right,
is there a definitive answer to that question?
Yes, there is, too.
What is definitive?
Everyone.
Okay, hon.
Niagara Falls.
I got it.
When we got there, he made me blank. All right, they're both writing. I guess I'll be ready any moment now. And we'll walk over here to Barbara. Ready? Judy said, my honeymoon was rotten. Sure, Sidney took me to Niagara Falls. But when we got there, he made me... blank. Niagara Falls, Barbara. You ever been to Niagara Falls?
Yes, I've been there.
You have?
Yes.
On your honeymoon?
No.
Oh. Think of something associated with Niagara Falls. Sure, he took me to Niagara Falls, but when we got there, he made me blank.
Swim.
Okay.
She
said swim. She drew a blank, kind of. She couldn't think of anything.
Ding dong.
What do you say? Well,
I almost said swim. Then
did
I thought of a couple other things. But I said go over in a barrel.
Go over in a barrel, D-boy. That's what they do there. Brett?
Go over in a barrel. He could have killed that poor little devil. I said, made her jump right into the little falls and have a
jump.
Swim.
Okay.
Not a match.
No.
I don't understand Gary's answer. Go over in a barrel?
Go over in a barrel. That was the thing everybody used to do and still do occasionally.
Oh, I never heard of that.
See if you can survive going over in a barrel.
Go over in a barrel.
Go over in a barrel. What do you associate with Niagara Falls, Sarah?
Well, I didn't know. Do they really go over in a barrel?
Sure.
Really?
Not in a regular barrel. It's a steel barrel lined with all kinds of flotation soft stuff so you don't get hurt.
Right.
Many people have been killed. A few have survived.
I believe that.
That's happened on their honeymoon, too.
What do we got?
I said jump.
Jump. One possibility. Richard?
Yump.
Yump over. Okay. Yes. And Fanny?
Did you know that, really, the first person who ever went over Niagara Falls in a barrel was a woman?
A woman?
Yep. Jump.
Jump. Is that a fact?
Fact.
Oh, boy. Now, Joe, all you got to do is match one celebrity, and you win another game. So far, I got no score here. All right. Here we go. Now, listen carefully.
Okay.
Little Billy was the only cannibal in the second grade, so at snack time, instead of a snack, Little Billy ate the blank.
He was the only camel in the second grade?
Only cannibal.
Oh, cannibal.
The only cannibal in the second grade. So at snack time, instead of a snack, Little Billy ate the...
I think I got it.
Okay, you got it.
Thank you, sweetheart.
The only camel in the second grade, eh?
Cannibal!
Oh.
Commendable.
Hey, not by the head.
Oh, gently, yes.
Yeah.
Sweet.
Is that
amazing
mean?
How insensitive people are to little furry things? It's terrible.
All right, Joe, Little Billy was the only cannibal in the second grade, so at snack time, instead of a snack, Little Billy ate the blank.
The teacher.
What? One teacher on toast wins the game.
On toast?
Or anyway, fricassee.
How about sunny side up?
Okay.
Teacher.
That wins the game. For the rest of the game.
What did he say?
Thank you. Now, gee, Barbara, you came loaded with gifts, and you're leaving not exactly empty-handed.
That's
because we
right.
do have some gifts for you.
Yes.
Together with our thanks for being with us on Match Game 76.
Thank you.
Audra Raskin and our few spinning off. We're spinning messages for you. Here's tall Joel Beyer. And this is the third time he's been up here. And once he collected the 5,000, once he didn't. Now we'll see how he does this trip. Ready, Joe?
Yes.
We polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Throwing blank. Now, the answer... the answer they gave most often is worth $500 if you match it. If you match the middle one, you get $250, and the bottom one gets you $100. Whom do you call on over here? They're allowed to suggest some answers.
Gary, please. Which is the way I feel about this match. Up.
Up.
Okay. And Fanny?
Oh, let's see. There's so many. Let's say throwing horseshoes.
Throwing horseshoes.
Well, let's don't say that.
That's pitching horseshoes.
No, then I have to take that back. Let's say throwing, that was a mistake on my part, and I do apologize. I say throwing darts.
Darts. All right. Throwing darts is hers.
And Charles?
Charles, don't panic.
Throwing, I got it.
You have?
I don't need any help. It's right on my card. Bring in your cameras. Throwing a fit.
Throwing a fit. Okay. So those are the throwing up, throwing a fit, and throwing darts. Now, last time you were up here, you went on your own and rejected all of the celebrities' answers and chose one yourself. Are you going to do the same thing?
You better.
No, I think Gary has the winner with throwing up.
It's the only thing you can do when you're sick.
There is something that goes against my nature when I hear you applauding barfing.
Oh, gee.
I don't like it. Not at all. May we see... the $100 number. Throwing a fit.
Ha, they scoffed at Charles.
Charles answered. We're looking for throwing up. May we see the $250 number? Throwing a ball. Okay.
Uh-oh. It's going to be darts.
Earl? I am extremely displeased with the throwing up answer. If it shows up when you slide this, I'm going to throw you out. Do you understand, Earl?
That's a 10-4 Roger.
10-4 Roger, he says, yes. He's got a CB radio in there. That's how we communicate with him. All right, Earl, slide it. Oh! Okay. All right. Well, Joe, that upchup got you another $500. You now have $6,550. You're going to play for 10 times the 500 or $5,000. You got to match one exactly. Which one will it be?
Richard, please.
Richard is the one. Okay, here we go. If you get this, you have $11,550. It goes like this. Rocket blank. That's R-O-C-K-E-T blank. Rocket blank. Well, he made up his mind very quickly there, Joe. Now we ask you to get your ESP going over to Richard Dawson and give us an answer that matches his. What do you say to that?
Rocket ship.
Yeah! Rocket ship. All right, Richard, he says rocket ship will match it for 5,000. What do you say?
Rocket to the moon. Ship.
Some of the other possibilities there. Rocket.
What was it?
What are some of the other possibilities with
rocket
that?
Rocket to the moon.
Rocket to the moon, yeah. That's
right.
Oh, that's
rocket,
very
bionic flag.
No.
Rocket throwing darts.
Okay, now he's got his 11,550, and now we're going to meet Melanie Almskov. Here we come.
Go.
Get up there. I guess you know each other. We'll find out a little bit about Melanie Almskog.
Well, I'm living in West LA right now, and I work for a local hospital as a mammogram technician, and I'm very single right now.
As a what kind of technician?
A mammogram.
a mammogram technician. I'm not going to ask what that is. I'll just go to a little commercial message and talk to you during this minute break here. This is the end, but there's more next time. Match Game 76, Gene Rayburn, goodbye.
Goodbye.